Hello dear students, welcome back to the chemistry class. In the last class, we have discussed about some commercial cells, that is batteries. In that case, we have discussed four batteries. Two types, one is primary and secondary batteries. In case of primary batteries, examples dry cell and mercury cell. Whereas in secondary batteries, we have studied about lead storage batteries and nickel cadmium battery. So let's have a quick revision on batteries. That means in the batteries, anode, cathode and electrolytes used in the batteries. What are the cell reactions? After completing this quick revision, we'll move to the next concept, that is fuel cells. Let's have a quick revision. Here, four batteries we have discussed, as you know. One is dry cell. First one is dry cell. So, let's start with that. Dry cell. Dry cell. Or Lagrangian cell. Lagrangian cell. So, in this dry cell, anode, cathode and electrolyte used. Anode is, in this case, anode, cathode, which anode, which cathode, and electrolyte used, electrolyte used, which electrolyte. So, first, dry cell. In dry cell, anode is zinc cylinder, whereas the cathode is graphite electrode. So in this case, we have used zinc is used as an anode, whereas graphite is used as cathode. And the electrolyte is, it is a paste of ammonium chloride and zinc chloride, and graphite is surrounded by manganese dioxide with coke powder. So cell reactions. Yeah, in this case we need to write three reactions. One is at anode where oxidation occurs. Here zinc is an anode. So zinc undergo oxidation. This gives rise to Zn2+ two electrons. Zinc undergoing oxidation. Second one, at cathode reduction reaction. Cathode, we have taken the graphite. So here electrolyte is NH4+ ions in the presence of MnO4. This NH4+ in the presence of MnO2, or we can write MnO2, which gains two electrons. This gives rise to the product NH3 gas is liberated, 2NH3 gas is liberated, plus 2MnOOH. MnOOH. Check out whether the reaction is balanced or not. Total number of hydrogens are 8, 6 here and 2 here. Okay, the reaction is balanced, 2 electrons is gained. Now, the overall reaction of dry cell is, zinc plus 2NH4+ plus 2MnO2. This gives rise to Zn2+ plus 2NH3 plus 2MnOOH. This is the overall cell reaction. Overall cell reaction. Your first dry cell. This is about dry cell. Note this. Dry cell. One is completed. Dry cell. in the dry cell anode and cathode. Anode is zinc, cathode is graphite, electrolytes used and cell reaction, anode, cathode and overall reactions we have written. Now let's come to the second one, mercury cell, mercury battery. In the mercury battery, again the zinc is used as an electrode, zinc is used as an electrode. Mercuric oxide, HZO, is used as an cathode. And here, potash is used as an electrolyte. So here, the anode reaction is zinc in the presence of 2OH minus, that is electrolyte. This gives rise to zinc oxide plus H2O plus 2 electrons are lost here. That means zinc, 0 oxidation state 2 plus 2, zinc undergoing oxidation. Whereas this mercuric oxide is reduced in the presence of 2 electrons. 2 electrons, this gives rise to mercury plus 2 oxygen, 2 hydrogen, 2 electrons, 2OH minus. The overall reaction do not involves the ions, because when we add H2O plus 2 electron, H2O plus 2 electrons get cancels. The overall reaction is zinc plus mercuric oxide gives rise to zinc oxide plus mercury. This is the overall reaction. And as you know that in dry cell, around 1.3 to 1.5 volt or 1.2 to 1.5 volt is the capacity of dry volt. Whereas mercury cell, it gives 1.35 volt exactly. This is the second cell. And these two comes under primary cells. These cannot be, the cell reaction cannot be reversed. Once these batteries are used, they become dead and we cannot use again and again by recharging. So this is about primary cells ke bare mein ho gaya. Now come to the second one, that is secondary batteries. In the secondary batteries, again we have studied two cells. The first one is, note this, continue is yahan par, third one, third and fourth. You make only one table. So this is first, second, third and fourth. I am writing here. So the third one is lead storage battery. So in the lead storage battery, anode, cathode, electrolyte and the cell reactions. Anode, cathode, electrolyte and the cell reactions. Anode is a grid of lead which is packed with finely divided spongy lead. So here lead is act as an anode, whereas cathode is a grid of lead oxide PbO2, and the electrolyte is, note this, 38% sulfuric acid which having a density of 1.30 grams per ml. Ye electrolyte. And here the anode reaction is, lead undergoing oxidation, lead in the presence of sulfate ions, that is electrolyte, gives rise to lead sulfate as a precipitate, lead sulfate plus loss of 2 electrons. This is anodic reaction. And at the cathode, lead oxide reduces in the presence of H plus ion, 4H plus ion plus 2 electrons plus 1 sulfate ion. This gives us to again lead sulfate precipitated at this case also plus lead sulfate is get precipitated, 2 oxygen plus 4 hydrogen, this gives us to 2H2O. The overall reaction in the lead storage battery is, note the overall reactions, lead plus lead oxide plus 4H plus plus 2 sulfate, 2 electron cancel out, 2 sulfate ions plus 4H plus. We can write 2H2SO4 directly. RL you can directly write 4H plus as it is plus 2 sulfate ion. That means it is 2 sulfuric acid. This gives us to 2 molecules of lead sulfate precipitated plus 2 H2O plus 2 molecules of S2. This is the overall equation. And in this case, in the lead storage battery, around 6 to 12 volt is its capacity. 6 to 12 volt is its capacity. Now look at this. If these are the reactions which takes place when we are using the batteries. When the battery is recharging, when battery is charged, so then some reactions get reversed. At anode, this reaction gets reversed. Anode becomes cathode, means reduction. Lead sulfate gains 2 electrons, which gives us to lead plus sulfate ions. Whereas, in this case, lead sulfate plus water, when electricity is passed, it gives us to lead oxide plus 4H plus sulfate ions, plus loss of these 2 electrons. And this cell also, this reaction, cell reactions also get changed when the battery is charging. During the charging of battery, all these 3 reactions exactly get reversed while using these other reactions. And this is third one, that is lead storage battery. The next one is nickel cadmium storage. In this case, the anode cathode ion, the overall reactions are here the anode is cadmium, cathode is nickel oxide, or we can write NiOH, thus nickel oxide is used in this case, nickel oxides are hydroxides, so here are directly you can write nickel oxide itself, and the electrolyte is potassium hydroxide, KOH solution. And here, anode reaction, oxidation reaction as this. When oxidation reaction, that is cadmium in the presence of 2OH minus gives us to cadmium oxide plus water plus loss of 2 electrons. Whereas at cathode, nickel hydroxide NiOH thrice, which gains 2 electrons, this gives us to nickel OH twice plus nickel OH twice plus 2 electrons is gained, so plus 2OH minus. The overall reaction is 2OH, 2 electron get cancels. Therefore, the overall reaction in this case is nickel OH thrice plus cadmium, this gives us to cadmium oxide plus nickel hydroxide plus H2O. This is the overall reaction, and in this case 1.40 volt is capacity. So these two are belongs to secondary cells. So this is a short and quick revision about the commercial cells. Note this table and then we'll move to the next concept, that is fuel cells. In the next class, we'll discuss about the fuel cells. Thank you.